Hello student, now in this video I am going to teach you working of capacitor and carbon microphone. Let's start first capacitor microphone. As you can see on your screen, this is the image of capacitor microphone and this is the internal diagram of capacitor microphone. So let's start its construction. It consists of two plates of capacitor, so it is called as a capacitor microphone. Out of two plate, one plate is movable because diaphragm is attached to one of plate of the capacitor. On the diaphragm we have applied that sound wave, so it is movable, and diaphragm is made by metal material. Second plate is fixed, also called as a back plate of capacitor. For the working we required a DC biasing supply. This is the one plate of capacitor, this is the diaphragm, this is the another plate of capacitor. In between the two plates of capacitor, this will be the insulating material, and this is the biasing supply. Working of capacitor microphone. We know that we have applied that sound waves and it is going to convert into electrical signal. When sound pressure wave was applied to the diaphragm, the distance between the plates of capacitor was decreased. As a result, capacitance increased. So the voltage across two plates of capacitor was decreased. So this is the formula for capacitance, that is epsilon A by D, where epsilon is the dielectric material constant, A is the area of plate of capacitor, where D is the distance between the two plates of capacitor. Student, epsilon is the dielectric material and area of the plate of capacitor was fixed. It cannot be changed. It is fixed during the manufacturing time. So the distance is going to the change. So distance between the plate was decreased. Capacitance was increased. Capacitance was increased, so the voltage across this capacitor was decreased. Student, we know that sound pressure wave contains compression, means high pressure, rarefaction means low pressure. So that sound waves was applied to the diaphragm. A distance of capacitor decrease or increase, it changes. So the capacitance also changes. As a result, change in voltage is appear across the capacitor. So change in voltage is nothing but AC output voltage, also we called as a electrical signal. So student, output voltage depend upon the distance between the two plates of capacitor and sound pressure waves. Some important characteristics of capacitor microphone, that is sensitivity. Output voltage is 3 millivolt. It is small, so we required that amplifier circuit. Signal to noise ratio, it is 40 dB and it is high. Frequency response, it is 40 Hz to 15 kHz. It is very good. And it is flat frequency response. Distortion, it is 1%. Directivity, that is omnidirectional, means the microphone can pick up sound in 360 directions. Output impedance is 100 mega ohm and it is high. Student, this is the second microphone topic. As you can see on your screen, this is the telephone. Now you think that a telephone device must contain a microphone. So you might be think that this carbon microphone is used in the telephone. So this is the internal diagram of carbon microphone. Its construction, it consists of two metal plates. In between the two metal plates, carbon garnier material are placed. So it is called as a carbon microphone. This is the carbon garnier materials. This is the one plate and this is the another plate. So one plate is attached to the diaphragm. This is the diaphragm where we have to apply that sound waves. And second plate is fixed. For the protection purpose, unit was covered with the holes. This unit was covered with the holes. And output is taken across a transformer. Here this is the output taken across the transformer. Operation. When sound wave was applied through diaphragm, carbon garnier's resistance is decreased. So at the output, current was increased in the circuit. So student, we know that sound pressure wave contains compression and rear fraction. Such type of wave was applied to the diaphragm. Diaphragm moves forward. So resistance of carbon garnier material decrease. As a result, output current in the circuit was increased. So output voltage is proportional to the resistance of carbon garnier as well as sound pressure waves. So student, in this carbon microphone, resistance of the carbon garnier material decrease with the applied of sound pressure waves. This is the working principle operation of carbon microphone. These are the some important characteristics of carbon microphone. First is sensitivity, that is output voltage of microphone, and it is high, that is below 1 volt. Signal to noise ratio is poor due to the random change in carbon garnier resistance. So hiss type noise was present at the output. Frequency response is 200 to 5 kilohertz. So it can be used in telephony. So telephony system contains bandwidth of less than 5 kilohertz. Distortion is 10% and it is high as compared to the other three microphones. So it can be due to the internal resistance of carbon material. Directivity is omnidirection, means microphone can pick up sound in 360 directions. Output impedance is low, that is 100 ohm. So student, in this video, we are cover two microphone. One is capacitor microphone. Second is carbon microphone. Capacitor microphone contains two plates of capacitor. So it is called as a capacitor microphone. And its working principle depends upon the distance between the two plates of capacitor. Carbon microphone consists of two plates of metal. In between the two plates, the carbon garnier material is used. According to the sound pressure waves, internal resistance of carbon garnier material is decreased. Such principle can be used to reproduce that conversion of sound waves into the electrical signal. If you have any questions, Please ask. Thank you for watching.